Our lives have followed a long path. But eventually, all roads reach their end.
Our world is broken, stagnant, fallen into the abyss.
But everything is born from darkness, even the universe itself.
Now, do you see it? A glimmer within the void.
The spark of life still burns,
and evolution forges a new way forward.
Once your faith overcomes despair, once you move beyond death, once life returns to this world, we'll meet beyond that path.
Liquid nitrogen, negative 195.79 Celsius. Physical movement or brain function, not detected. Subject status, stable. Dagger still stuck in the sheath. Inspection 481 complete. Requesting a higher power outlay for the isolation chamber to prevent any further outages. What's that? Secure me, breach. Secure me, breach!
Ugh. Well, it's good to see another face. I thought I was on my own. And you're a metahuman, too. I don't know who you are, but I know what you are. You awakened the cradle. And that's something only a metahuman could do. You've lost your memory. Do you remember who you are? It must have been that fluctuation just now. It trapped me in the cradle. It could have robbed you of your memories. You can call me V. It seems that our interests are aligned, metahuman. I came to secure a deviation. A paper butterfly. But I think something must have scared it. Right now, though, we need to move. I can show you the way out of this place, but only if you help me complete my mission first. All right? All you have to do is listen to what I tell you. Stardust. It's called a deviant. Our world has been overrun. Ordinary humans can't take high levels of stardust exposure. When they do, they end up just like that thing. But you're a metahuman. You should be fine. In fact, if the conditions are right, you might even be able to use stardust to your advantage. Come on. ET-011? My name is Victor Hammett. What's your name?
I don't know. All I know is that I'm a monster. My mother, my father, and everyone else. They're gone. And it was all my fault.
Hey, hey. Try and stay calm. I'm here. And I will do everything to help.
It's no use. No one can help me. It'd be better for everyone if I just leave me alone. Please, don't waste your time on me. My butterfly, it's flying.
Yes, your first deviation. And look how gentle it is.
I remember my name now. It's Mitsuko. It means child of light. It's my first creation.
Something powerful to challenge the evolutionists. And I think I finally found it. You. Hey, we can secure other deviations. We can use them to forge a new path and bring about true evolution. This will be the Mayfly's mission. This is why we'll fight.
Mayflies?
That's right. Mayflies. Small, yet invincible. Humanity may seem puny now, but we'll prove we can endure. Reach out your left hand, and see if you can feel the rhythm of it. Then, try and secure it. And look what I found. A Meta. Only just woken up. They were kind enough to activate the cradle and set me free.
Thank you, Meta-human. Your help means a lot to me. You can call me Mitsuko. I used to be a Meta-human as well. Rosetta did all kinds of experiments on me. That is, until V saved me.
Mitsuko is a very special Meta. She can sense even the tiniest fluctuations in the Stardust. It's thanks to her that I was able to take refuge in this place after Starfall. You're safe here.
Yes. The butterfly is an emissary of sorts. I wanted it to help rescue other metas. The recent fluctuation must have startled it. The important thing right now is to secure it and ensure its safety. See that thing in the center of the room? It's a device for securing deviations. This makes them more useful and safer to be around. The butterfly is recovered. I think it likes you. Deviations can be very dangerous if not taken care of. They can radiate stardust, which can lead to all kinds of unpredictable consequences. This is why we created the Mayflies. We make cradles and securement units to keep deviations contained. We're finding ways for humans and deviations to live in harmony. This is our best chance of cleaning up Rosetta's mess.
No one's exactly sure what they are. Just that they're not bound by the physical laws of our world. They came from another dimension. Something we call Rift Space. When deviations get stressed, they release stardust. We think this brings our world and Rift Space closer together. Sometimes, it becomes possible to pass between the two planes of existence. And when that happens, all hell breaks loose. We believe that's what caused Starfall.
Some deviations are friendly, like the butterfly. But others, like the ones inside monoliths, are extremely dangerous. It's not practical to secure all of them. But if we can learn more about them, maybe we can find ways to live alongside them. That's the goal. You must be prepared. The stardust just keeps spreading, and we aren't sure why. Be careful! That must be a siren!
Shit, it must have gotten through. Come on, Meta. A deviation from another world just entered this space, and it won't go down without a fight. Take the butterfly with you. It can help. Damn. It escaped.
That was a difficult fight. Just driving it away was enough. And it's all thanks to you, Meta, for saving us.
You're tougher than you look. That's twice now you saved me. Yes. Mitsuko created this rift space. A refuge from the dangers of the physical world. Or so we thought.
Do you think that deviation will come back? What if it returns with greater disruptions?
It's possible. We can't just sit here and wait, though. Meta, will you go back to the physical world with me?
Take the butterfly with you. Put it in your cradle. That way, I can lend you some of my strength. Hopefully we'll meet again one day. When the Stardust is stable enough. It looks like this is goodbye. Good luck, Meta. Before you go, if you have any questions, I can try and answer them for you.
Look at that. 20 years after Starfall, and the world is still infested with Stardust. It looks like the monoliths here have been reactivated too. They might hold the key to all the Stardust pollution. Set up a territory. Nice work. I've managed to unlock some memetics from Mitsuko. If you access them through your cradle, you'll be able to craft and build what we need. Even with memetics, you still won't be able to craft anything out of thin air. We'd better gather some ore and logs. also need a furnace and a disassembly bench to process the materials we gather. Use the furnace to refine raw materials into something more practical. We'll need it for advanced items. Nice. This is a strong foundation for us to build upon. I've set up a journey interface to help track our progress. For each task you complete, you'll unlock some supplies we can use. Thank you. So far, what we've got won't do much against those deviants out there. We need proper weapons and armor. There are some abandoned Rosetta facilities nearby. Maybe we could find some useful supply crates there. I've marked their locations on your map.
Thank you. hands off my stuff. You're pretty cocky for someone who doesn't even have a weapon. Quite impressive, to be honest. Hold on. Is that a cradle on your back? Are you a Mayfly? How interesting. I thought I was the only Mayfly left. I'm Mary. It's a good thing I met you. I'm thinking as fellow Mayflies, we should be able to help each other out. I came here to investigate a deviation that's been causing issues. I think it's connected to a recently reopened monolith nearby. Don't tell me you're going to try and take on a powerful deviation barehanded. Even an ordinary deviant could tear you apart right now. You're pretty inexperienced, aren't you? I'm going to give you a blueprint. Use it to make yourself a gun. Trust me, you'll need one if you want to stand even half a chance of surviving out there. While you're doing that, I have other matters to attend to. Once you're done, come find me in Deadsville. It's the nearest survivor settlement. We can plan our next steps from there. After all, two heads are better than one. And I'd never turn down help.
So another Mayfly survived. Yet I can't remember her. My memory's been patchy ever since Mitsuko revived me. Just to be safe, we'd better not share the existence of Mitsuko with that woman. That blueprint is rock solid, though. We can use it to make a real gun. Let's check your memetics and start by building a gear workbench.
Thank you.
Great, we can use that blueprint to make both guns and ammo. If you want to make ammo, though, you'll need to do it at a synthesis bench. Good. I'm sure you'll need that weapon soon enough. Wait. I just noticed a teleportation tower was activated at Deadsville. Did Mary do that? We can use it to teleport straight there. Open your map and try it out. Activating teleportation towers will let us get to places much faster and avoid any dangers along the way.
Good. You made it. I'm guessing that gun served you well. Yeah, this was the quickest way to bring you here. These towers are even supposed to let you travel between worlds, but I haven't been able to figure out how. Maybe you'll have more luck. Either way, I'm glad it got you here. Deadsville is the perfect place to dig up info on the area. That merchant over by the old truck looks like she gets around. Maybe she knows something useful.
Come take a look. Anything that catches your eye, I'm always open for business. Wait, I've never seen you before, but you're a Mayfly, ain't you? Oh, thank goodness. I could really use some help. My name's Claire. Claire Lay. Normally, I'm a wandering merchant, but now I'm stuck here. I sent a team over to a place called the Rotten Manor 3 days ago to collect some goods for me, but they never came back.
It's possible that they ran off with the goods.
Don't be so cynical. I've been through thick and thin with them. They wouldn't do that to me. I'm afraid that something must have happened to them. Rumor is, the Rotten Manor seen a surge of deviants recently. I suspect there's a deviation behind it. All I know is what I heard from that well-dressed gentleman over there. He should be able to tell you more.
There's no question. That guy stands out. We'd better talk to him and see what he knows.
Good luck. Oh, and I'll happily pay a reward if you can recover my stuff for me. I'll mark Rotten Manor on your map. Make sure to stock up on ammo before you go, all right?
And know the place for the first time, through the unknown, unremembered gate. Ah, a mayfly, and one who seems to be brimming with potential. A pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Do you know about a deviation affecting this area?
You've come to the right man. I am Samuel Lowe. A humble scholar, specializing in the fascinating phenomena we call deviations. And as for you, you seek keys with which to unlock the Dark Tower, don't you? But I'd be wary of what else you might open up.
Do you always speak in riddles like this?
I was merely setting the mood. The world still deserves something poetic, don't you think? Now, you're interested in the deviation inside that monolith, aren't you? But the tower is locked up tight, and its keys are rift anchors across the wetlands.
Rift anchors? Those things are made by Rosetta, aren't they? Activating them should give us access to the rift space inside the monolith.
Spot on. And now tell me, where do you think those anchors would be?
Usually places with the heaviest stardust pollution. The Rotten Manor would definitely be one of them.
Indeed. I'm looking forward to seeing what you can do, Mayfly. I'm sure it will be a remarkable story to share. By the way, I wouldn't mind adding another deviation to my collection.
Now that we know what to do, let's split up to cover more ground. I'll find a way to hack into the monolith. Once you've activated the rift anchors, come meet me at the monolith gate. Just don't forget to bring plenty of ammo. That place must be packed with deviants. Oh, and one more thing. I have a motorcycle here you can use. That should help speed things along.
Oh yeah, this looks like it'll be fun to ride.
Those who dream by day are cognizant of many things which escape those who dream only by night. Very good. I'm an admirer of his. My name is Samuel Lowe. It has the appearance of a small metal toy. It is not dangerous, so they say, but it can't be left alone. I think it is a good place to start. My sources tell me it is hidden somewhere in Thruville. Not too far away, but do not delay. There are others in search of such treasures. This little guy seems to be fascinated by metals and ores. If you have some copper ore or ingots on you, you should be able to make nice with him.
The Stardust concentration here is off the charts. We should set up a campsite before rushing into the rotten matter. That way we can recover more quickly if anything goes wrong. those goods. Too bad her team didn't make it, though. Look at this substance. It must have come from that festering gel deviation. Elsewhere, quite similar to what we encountered here. I've marked their locations. Hopefully, we'll find the other rift anchors there.